Hey, what's up, guys? It's time for another The Bold and the Beautiful review. And I wasn't really feeling this week's episodes. Just kind of blahed me. I don't know. Sorry, my allergies are acting up. I swear talking makes my nose itch even more. But anyways, I don't know if it was really me or was it actually the show, because I was kind of pretty bored with all the other soaps and shows I was watching this week, and just everyday life, which is very blah to me. So I don't know, it could have just been me, but they just seem like they're back to, you know, the repetitive scenes and conversations again. That just bores me. And there was no shaking. No follow-up on Sheila. There was no follow-up on Sheila, and we didn't see Deacon, so it was kind of like, it was all about, you know, or Thomas and Hope getting close, how they're feeling, blah, blah, blah. That was basically this week's episodes. And that's it in my review. No, but, I didn't take any notes either. I didn't realize I didn't until I was looking at the notes, and I realized that these are, I didn't even erase the notes from last week's episodes. It's like, this did not happen this week. This was last week, so it's going, all coming from my head. I did watch every episode same day, except for Friday's episode, yesterday's episode. I watched that this morning, so I guess that's kind of fresh in my head, though I wasn't really paying that close attention to it. But anyways, what I thought was kind of, we'll talk about what happened, the continuation of what happened last Friday into Monday's episodes. Hope planned this romantic evening for her and Liam. And they're, like, about to have sex, and she sees Thomas, and they still have sex. They're, like, on the couch, and she's looking up, and she sees Thomas, and I'm, like, and it's, like, she just wants Liam even more. So she just admitted it to herself that she wants Thomas, which I don't blame her. Beards are really hot. And Liam's very hot. So, I don't blame Hope for wanting some, what's the word? Some excitement. I was going to go another word, but I'm going to stick with excitement in her life. But the shit with Hope is right after. She's like, I need to go tell to my mom. Like, we just had sex and you want to go talk to your mom? So, I'm like, you want to tell your mom how horrible it was? Or that you just saw Thomas on top of you. But anyways, yeah, she goes back to the house and she sees Brooke and Ridge talking together. It's like, wow. She's like, I'm just looking at ourselves. Her older self in her 90s trying to seduce Thomas. Speaking of Hope, I was talking about this last week. I was like, I don't know, is she really trying to stay away from Ridge, or is she really trying to seduce his ass with that outfit? And then Monday, it was like they're about to kiss, but then she's like, no, I have to stick to friendship with Taylor. That's more important. And basically, Ridge just had to go home and take a cold shower. But the shit was, Hope came in and just, I remember this scene so well, because I was like, Brooke was a good one, and she didn't turn around and just slap the living shit out of that little brat of hers. This way, Hope was just going off on her about how she just jumps from man to man, and she's like, I had to, you know, deal with that my whole life, seeing you do that, you know, you're done with one man, you go to another, and I'm not like you, I'm not like you. And I'm like, Hope, it sounds like you kind of are like her, because you're just going off for no reason. Yeah, and I always believe that, if you're going off on somebody about their flaws or whatever, it's really you. You're really telling them off about something inside of you that you don't like, whether it's the same thing or it's just something that you hate about yourself that you wish that you could change, basically. So that's why I was thinking that was Hope. She's just mad at herself for having feelings for Thomas when she's married to Liam. And that's another thing she was talking about. She's married, she's not gonna stay faithful to her marriage and blah blah blah. So with her saying that and then Liam talking to Steffi, I don't know, they're talking Thursday and Friday, but I think it was Thursday's episode they're talking about. He says that he trusts Steffi. He trusts Hope, and that's what's important. So that just makes me think, I don't think you should be trusting Hope. So I think she's gonna be the one to put the moves on Thomas, because I truly believe Thomas is actually trying to change. And I think Hope is just going to destroy that or derail it really badly, because she's has the hots for him now that he's changing. She's seeing the good in him again. And well, I wasn't around when they were together, so I'm guessing he was a better guy, and then he just kind of went downhill. So I guess she's seeing that Thomas that she fell for. What do you, I'm assuming that they, well, I know they were together, but I'm assuming that they were in love. And I mean, because, Thomas considers her Douglas's mom, and they're so close, so I'm assuming that they were in love once upon a time. So I'm guessing she's now seeing that love again, the man that she fell in love with, and so that's why she's imagining him on top of her. She's thinking about him. Yeah, so yeah, Liam ended up showing up there later to check it out. It's like they were hoping Brooke, they ended up hugging afterward. Brooke's like, "What's going on? What's going on?" And they ended up hugging it out. But yeah, 'cause I wonder what they did with Beth and Douglas, but they scheduled Brooke. Brooke said it. They had scheduled them some, what do you call it, sleepovers for them last minute. Be like, here, take my kid. I'm gonna bring my husband. Basically, while envisioning my other husband. Oh, Lordy, and that's some shit. Oh Lord, if I was a mom. But yeah, Brooke was I'm sorry, I was typing up something. To remind me of something. What was I gonna say? Oh, Brooke was telling Taylor about how Hope, Liam, Beth, and Douglas weren't at the dinner. So Taylor's like, "Oh, it's just you and Rich." She's like, "Yeah, nothing happened though." She's like, "We're friends. We're still BFFs." Yeah, but Rich was talking to Taylor, saying that, "Hey, it's our turn next." And Taylor's like, "Oh, cool. We can have our children and grandchildren all together. Yay!" And if they don't show up, then we can have, I will cancel it. No, I will spend time with you by myself. I say it's only fair. Like I've said before, it's only fair that Taylor and Ridge spend alone time together. But Taylor was talking about she was gonna smother her children. I'm like, They already spoiled as fuck, so might as well. And Ridge was talking about they're adults. How are you gonna do that? And I'm like, they're children still, because they did all this shit to try to put y'all back together. I don't see them as well. They acting more adulty lately, by parenting and working. So, yeah, we did see some scenes with like I said, Steffi and Liam. I really see them together, and I keep forgetting that Kelly is Liam's daughter, not Finn's. So that's when they were like sharing scenes, talking about, you know, Kelly playing soccer and stuff, and I'm like, I forgot their parents together. And seeing them in the scenes together, I'm like, they were a couple? Like, they just don't fit right together. I guess, I don't know. Maybe because I've seen Steffi and I wasn't watching when Steffi and Liam were together. That could be maybe, or it could be my hatred for Liam. Or it could just be me really liking Steffi and Finn. Because I guess I can classify myself as a Sin fan, I guess, maybe. I do enjoy them. They're the only couple on the show that I see regularly that I like. But I mean, besides, well, Sheila and Deacon aren't together anymore. You know my love for Yeah, but I thought it was, I guess, kind of cute them watching a video of Kelly knocking down some kid. Oh, lordy. But does she have her, which family name that, I don't know, heard something outside. So, who last name does she have? Is it Kelly Forster or Kelly Spencer? I don't know. It definitely ends in R. Speaking of which, we did not get to see any Bill this week either. And no follow-up on Bill and Katie making out. Is Oh lordy. That was last week. That was early last week when Kelly and Bill kissed. So that was Monday's episode when they kissed. So I'm like, so we're going on 2 weeks and I'll follow up on that kiss. So, I don't know. But yeah, no really big, nothing. I don't even think I mentioned Sheila this week, did I? I probably did and I just blocked it out because of the repetitiveness. But I did think it was funny with Brooke and Taylor talking about their friendship in front of Ridge, and he's like, they started hugging and he was trying to get in on it. I'm like, I'm surprised they haven't done the sister wife thing. Apparently that's an in thing now. I mean, I know it's been around for years, but I mean, you know, they have shows about it now, so I'm like, lordy, that just makes me think, lordy, are they really gonna do that? Are they really going to is that something that they would do? They can all move into Brooke's place because Ridge don't, he'd be staying at his dad's house. So I remember Brooke told him he could sleep on the couch. Now that I think about it, she got that big ass mansion. She doesn't have any of the spare rooms or anything. Or she has a special room for everything. I'm gonna stop talking. I'm not gonna say nothing. Also, there was no follow-up on Lee and Finn with them Lee not wanting to help Sheila and stuff. Yeah, I'll hope to see a scene with Lee and Bill together talking about Sheila not liking Sheila and how Lee just wanted her to die. And he just wanted Sheila out of his bed, out of his life. I don't know, but yeah, I'm sorry. I just wasn't feeling this week enough to really go into great detail about everything that happened, because I just feel like nothing really truly stood out or happened, really. So I'm gonna stop talking and, just let me know what you enjoy and didn't enjoy this week. And if my nose stopped itching. And if you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't, even though this is probably not a good example of what I do in my reviews. Usually more extensive. I don't know the word. Anyways, share this video, even if it's just to make fun of me. I don't know. Anything. But I don't know. I'm gonna shut up and stop talking. I'm hungry. I'm gonna go make some lunch. It's a beautiful day here. It's supposed to be bright, sunny, and warm for the rest of the weekend. I hope it's good weather where you guys are, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your weekend. And I'll see you guys here next week, hopefully. I love y'all so much. Thank you for watching, as always. Bye!